four J's. And these are public companies of Japan. And they are JBIC, which stands for Japan Bank for International Cooperation, JICA, which stands for Japan International Cooperation Agency, JETRO, which stands for Japan External Trade Organization, and JOGMEC, which stands for Japan Oil Minerals, Gas Minerals Exploration Company. So these are the public companies that you would want to work together with. And the persons who will guide you in my embassy is that we have a commercial attaché, Mr. Sugano, who is a very important person to contact. And I must also mention the role of the Sogo Shosha. I did mention that they are the key in understanding why Japan is the number three trading partner for South Africa. The Sogo Shosha, and they are Mitsubishi, Mitsui, Sumitomo, Itochu, Marubeni, and Sojitsu. So these are the trading houses now turning more and more into investment houses. And you want to, in many cases, if it's a big project, work together with these Sogo Shosha, because they have a lot of knowledge of accessing into the public programs that are available from the Japanese government. Now, Japan is a very energy efficient economy. So what we need to think globally is to have a single framework which will incorporate all the major emitters in an equitable way and also effective way. And the principle of same but differentiated approach, of course, should apply. But we're not going to get that this year. And many people speculate that we won't really be negotiating that until 2013. Japan is very interested in actual action on the ground. And this is why we have been assisting the so-called adaptation and mitigation efforts in Africa. We have pledged that in 2 years, from last year and this year, we will provide for short-term fast-track measures. Of the 1.5 billion that has been pledged, 1.2 billion is already dispersed. And we have put forward the vision for Africa for achieving a low carbon growth sustainable development strategy. And this was discussed in the Dakar meeting of the TICAD follow-up. And the plan is to have this strategy by the end of next year so that we will be able to discuss at the heads of state level in the TICAD 5 meeting in 2013. We think the current system of the CDMs is very inflexible, it's very time-taking and costly. And there should be a more flexible and effective way of using the market economy to achieve actual reductions of carbon emissions. And this is why we have taken an initiative to begin dialogues with a number of countries on a bilateral offset credit mechanism. And in this approach, it will certainly help Japan to offset its emissions and will assist the developing countries in achieving their NAMA, which is the nationally appropriate mitigation targets. Thank you.